Hello everyone, hope you are all safe in your home. So today we are going to see about the expression for depth of hydraulic jump. I am Dr. Surya. And what is hydraulic jump? So it is nothing but it's a rise of water level that is taking place due to transformation of supercritical flow to subcritical flow. So when the flow transfers from supercritical flow to subcritical flow, then your hydraulic jump occurs. Where does it occur? Generally it occurs when the flow is under a sluice gate. It will accelerate the hydraulic jump. So we are going to see different expressions for the hydraulic jump. So the first expression what we are going to see is expression for depth of a hydraulic jump. So the first assumptions what we are going to consider is the flow is going to be a uniform flow. So uniform flow is nothing but wherever throughout the length of the channel the depth is going to be a constant one, and the pressure distribution will be an hydrostatic one with before and after the jump, and the losses due to friction we are going to neglect that losses. And the next is that we are also going to neglect the component of the weight of the fluid. These are the general assumptions we are going to take for the consideration for to derive the expression for depth of hydraulic jump. And now consider, so this is a channel. So what happens is that this is going to be my hydraulic jump. So that is the transformation from subcritical flow to supercritical flow. Supercritical flow to subcritical flow. So what happens is we are going to assume the dip. What are the forces that are acting on the mass of water between this section 1-1 and section 2-2 are? So the first force will be my pressure force P1, so which is acting at the section 1-1, and the second force will be the pressure force P2, which is going to act under the section 2-2, and another one force that will be acting will be the frictional force, and we are going to neglect that frictional force. Now apart from that, we are going to consider D1 will be the depth of flow at section 1-1, D2 be the depth of flow at section 2-2, correspondingly V1, V2, Z1 bar is the depth of centroid of area at section 1-1, and A1 will be going to be the area of cross section at section 1-1, and apart from that we are going to consider the unit width of the channel. So now we all know that discharge per unit width Q is equal to V1 T1. So as per the continuity equation, so Q will be equal to V1 T1 into V2 D2. So keep this as equation 1. Now, and we know that pressure will be equal to force by area. So my pressure force will be equal to rho g A1 Z1 bar, or since because it is pressure force 1, we are going to consider the Z1 and area as A1. So Z1 is nothing but my depth of centroid. So Z1 will be D1 by 2, and A will be equal to B into D. And since because we are considering the unit width of the channel, the width becomes 1. So my pressure P1 will become rho g D1 into D1 by 2. So P1 will be equal to rho g D1 squared by 2. So this is will be at section 1-1. So correspondingly my P2 will be equal to rho g D2 squared by 2. Now we are going to calculate the net force acting on the mass of water. So the force is acting on the mass of water between the section 1-1 and 2-2. So force is acting between the section 1-1 and 2-2. This will be equal to P2 minus P1. So already we have derived for P1 and P2. Just we are going to substitute the value. So the net force will be equal to rho g D2 squared by 2 minus rho g D1 squared by 2. So here we are having a common rho g, so take this rho g outside, so it becomes, you can take rho g by 2 outside, so it becomes rho g by 2 D2 square minus D1 square. So this will be my equation 2. Then we are all heard of the momentum principle. So what is that momentum principle? So momentum principle is nothing but rate of change of momentum is equal to mass of water per second into change of velocity in the direction of force. So we are going to apply this momentum principle. So I'll keep this momentum principle equation as 3. So first I am going to determine what is the mass of water per second. So how we are going to calculate? We all know that density is equal to mass by volume. So my mass will be equal to density into volume. So instead of volume, I am just applying as discharge per unit width into width. So this becomes rho into discharge per unit width is nothing but my Q, and my unit width is going to be 1, so 1. So this mass per water per second is equal to rho Q. So I'll keep this as equation number 4. So next I have to determine the change of velocity in direction of force. So this is very simple, which is V1 minus V2. So this will be my fifth equation. Okay, so generally why we are taking it as V1 minus V2 is the net force will be acting from the right to left. So the change of velocity we should take from right to left. So hence it becomes V1 minus V2. So rate of change of momentum will be equal to so already we have used the formula, so which is nothing but mass of water per second into change of velocity in the direction of force, and we have determined mass of water per second as rho Q, and we have determined the change of velocity as V1 minus V2. So we are going to substitute 4 and 5 in 3. So which is nothing but rho Q V1 minus V2. So keep this as equation number 6. So according to the momentum principle, my equation 2 will be equal to equation 6. Okay, so which is nothing but rho g by 2 d2 square minus d1 square is equal to rho q v1 minus v2. So we are going to derive this. So we also know that q is equal to v1 d1 is equal to v2 d2. So from this my v1 will be equal to q by d1 and v2 will be equal to q by d2. So I am taking the equation rho g by 2 d2 square minus d1 square is equal to rho q into v1 minus v2. Now I can cancel this rho. So this becomes g by 2 d2 square minus d1 square, which is equal to q into, instead of v1 I can substitute q by d1, and instead of v2 I am substituting q by d2. Okay, now so this becomes g by 2 d2 square minus d1 square is equal to, I can take this common as q, so q squared into 1 minus d1 minus 1 minus d2. So next g by 2 into d2 square minus d1 square is equal to q square d2 minus d1 divided by d1 d2. Okay, now apply the principle a squared minus b squared. So a squared minus b squared is nothing but a minus b into a plus b. So applying the same principle here, d2 squared minus d1 squared becomes d2 minus d1 into d2 plus d1. So which is equal to q squared into d2 minus d1 divided by d1 d2. So here d2 minus d1 and d2 minus d1 I can cancel it off. So g by 2 into d2 plus d1 will be equal to q squared by d1 d2. So now I am rearranging this, so which becomes d2 plus d1 will be equal to 2q squared by g into d1 d2. I'm keeping this as capital A because we are going to use this equation in some other expression. So I'm for that purpose I'm keeping it this capital A. So this multiply equation capital A by d2. So I'll be getting d2 squared plus d1 d2, which is equal to 2q squared by g d1. So again I am rearranging plus d1 d2 minus 2q squared by g d1 is equal to 0. So this is the equation which is in the form of quadratic equation. So if it is in the form of quadratic equation, we can follow the principle, that is we can follow the rule, that is for to derive the roots we will be using minus b plus or minus root of b squared minus 4ac by 2a. So using this equation we can determine the roots of d2. So the same we are going to use it here. So my d2 will be equal to here minus b, that is my d1 will be my minus b. So minus d1 plus or minus root of d1 square minus 4 into my a value is 1 here, that is here it is 1, d2 is there 1, and my c value is minus 2q squared by gd1. So minus 2q squared by gd1 divided by 2 into a, that is my 1. So my d2 will be equal to minus d1 plus or minus root of d1 square, and here you can see this minus sign and this minus sign, it will become plus, and 4 into 2 will become 8. So plus 8 q squared by g d1 divided by 2. So this we can separate as minus d1 by 2 plus or minus, I am taking this 2 inside, so which becomes d1 squared by 4 plus, so again it becomes, when I am taking this inside it becomes 4. So if it becomes 4, so 4 and 8 it will get cancelled and it will become 2q squared by gd1. Okay, so now I am getting the two roots, which is d2 will be equal to minus d1 by 2 plus root of d1 squared by 4 plus 2q squared by gd1, as well as d2 is equal to minus d1 by 2 minus of root of d1 squared by 4 minus 2q squared by gd1. And this root is not possible because all the values are negative signs, so we cannot have the negative depth, so we can neglect this root, and we are going to consider only this value. So my d2 will be equal to minus d1 by 2 plus root of d1 squared by 4 plus 2q squared by gd1. So again we are going to use this equation, so I am keeping it as b. Okay, now we know that, again we know that q is equal to v1 d1, So I'm just going to substitute here. So d2 is equal to minus d1 by 2 plus root of d1 squared by 4 plus 2 into v1 squared d1 squared by g d1. So 1 d1 and d1 will get cancelled. So I'll be getting d2 will be equal to minus d1 by 2 plus root of d1 squared by 4 plus 2v1 squared d1 by g. Okay, this will be the value of depth at section 2, 2. So the generally the depth of hydraulic jump or we call it as standing wave. So the height of standing wave will be equal to d2 minus d1. So this is going to be the equation number 8. Hope you are all clear about your depth of hydraulic jump. Now we are going to derive the expression for loss of energy due to hydraulic jump. So generally when a hydraulic jump is taking place, there will be a loss of energy because the eddies will be formed and the turbulence will be occur. So because of that, there will be a loss of energy. So it is very, very important to determine the expression for the loss of energy. So what is this loss of energy here? So loss of energy is nothing but difference in the specific energy. So loss of energy is difference in specific energy. So I am denoting by loss of energy as HL and specific energy difference is E1 minus E2. So we have all learnt about specific energies. So we know the formula for specific energy as E1 is equal to D1 plus V1 squared by 2G and E2 is equal to D2 plus V2 squared by 2G. Now I am just going to apply here. So my HL will be equal to, so instead of E1 I am just substituting D1 plus V1 squared by 2G and instead of E2 I am substituting D2 plus V2 squared by 2G. Don't forget to put the bracket else you will make a careless mistake. Now we can rearrange it, that is bring all the velocities to one side and depth to other side. So which is V1 squared minus 2G. So taking into consideration of this minus sign, it becomes V1 squared minus V2 squared by 2G. Again, I am keeping this minus sign here. So already D2 minus D1 because you are having a plus sign here. So when I am putting minus here, this minus and minus, it will become plus. So I am rearranging it as D2 minus D1. Okay, now again we are coming to our continuity equation, which is nothing but Q is equal to V1 D1. So V1 will be equal to Q by D1 and V2 will be equal to Q by D2. So I am going to substitute this velocity value here. So my HL will be equal to, so instead of V1 I am substituting Q by D1. So here I am having V1 squared. So Q by D1 squared. So already I am having my 2G here minus Q squared by 2G D2 squared minus of D2 minus D1. Now here I am having common as Q squared by 2G is common. So I am taking it as outside. So it becomes 1 by D1 squared minus 1 by D2 squared minus of D2 minus D1. Q squared by 2G. So I am just multiplying. So which is D2 squared minus D1 squared divided by D1 squared D2 squared minus d2 minus d1. Okay, so this equation I am taking it as 9th equation. Now, so already we have seen from equation A, so I have kept one equation as capital A. So I'm going to use that equation. So that is the equation, again I'm writing that equation, that is d2 plus d1 will be equal to 2q squared by gd1 d2. So this is the equation A which you have kept earlier. So from this I am rearranging, so q squared is equal to gd1 d2 into d2 plus d1 divided by 2. So I am keeping this equation 10. So instead of q square, that is which is present here, instead of that q square I am going to substitute this value, so which is nothing but you are going to substitute 10 in 9. So which is my HL will be equal to, instead of q squared I am substituting g into d1 d2 by 2 d2 plus d1. Okay, and already I am having d2 square minus d1 square divided by 2g d1 square d2 square minus of d2 minus d1. So just see here, so in the place of q squared alone I am just substituting the value, other all the things I am keeping it as same. Okay, now this g and this g will get cancelled, 1d1 and 1d2 will get cancelled, so the remaining thing I have is d2 plus d1. So here 1 2 and here 1 2 is there, so it becomes 4, and this is d2 square minus d1 square minus d2 minus d1. Okay, now again d2 plus d1 by 4 I am keeping as it is, and if you see this is in the form of a square minus b square, so we all know the formula for that. Or that is a squared minus b squared is nothing but a plus b into a minus b. So I am writing it here d2 minus d1 into d2 plus d1 minus of d2 minus d1. Okay, now if you see here the common thing you have is your d2 minus d1. So I can take that as outside. So HL is equal to d2 minus d1. I am taking this as outside. So what I will have is, so if I take this here, so here d2 plus g1 square is there, because here one d2 plus g1 is there, here also d2 plus g1 is there. So I am just taking that. So d2 plus d1 the whole square divided by, so what I have is, so I have missed one d1 d2 here, so I am writing it here. Okay, divided by 4 into d1 d2, and here you see I have taken this d2 minus d1 outside, so it becomes minus 1, so which is equal to d2 minus d1. So again it is in the form of a plus b the whole square, so the formula will be a square plus 2ab plus b square, so it is in the same way. So d2 square plus 2 into d1 d2 plus d1 square, so this 4d1 d2 I am taking it here common, so 4d1 d2 divided by 4 into d1 d2. Okay, now d2 minus d1 into, so if you take it here minus 4d1 d2 is here plus, so this becomes d2 square minus 2d1 d2 plus d1 square divided by 4d1 d2. So again it is in the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square. So we can rearrange and we can write it as a minus b the whole square. So my HL will be equal to d2 minus d1 divided by 4d1 d2. So this becomes d2 minus d1 the whole square. So when I multiply, I'll be getting HL is equal to d2 minus d1 the whole cube divided by 4d1 d2. So this will be the equation for loss of energy due to hydraulic jump. So this I am going to keep it as equation number 11. So we have one more equation, one more derivation. So which is nothing but expression for depth of hydraulic jump in terms of Froude number. Okay, so we all know the formula for Froude number. So Froude number is for section 1, it becomes FR1 is equal to V1 by root of GD1. So this I will be keeping it as equation number 12. So already we have derived the equation. So from equation B, so I am writing the equation B again here. D2 is equal to minus D1 by 2 plus root of D1 squared by 4 plus 2Q squared by GD1. So this is the equation B which we have derived earlier. So in here, instead of Q, I am substituting B1 D1. So D2 will be equal to minus D1 by 2 plus root of D1 squared by 4 plus 2 into V1 square D1 square divided by GD1. Okay. Now, what I am going to do is, we are going to take in common D1 squared by 4. Root of D1 squared by 4. So, which is 1 plus, since because I am taking here, it becomes 8. Because when 4 is get 8 is getting divided by 4, you will be getting the value as 2. So, it becomes 8 into V1 squared. Already I have taken this D1 squared outside. 8 V1 squared by GD1. Okay. So now, which is equal to minus D1 by 2 plus. So here you are having D1 squared by 4. So when I am taking it outside the root, it becomes D1 by 2 into root of 1 plus 8 V1 squared by GD1. So this I am keeping it as equation number 13. So from 12, so what is our equation 12? It is FR1 is equal to V1 by root GD1. Then FR1 square will be equal to V1 square divided by GD1. So this I am going to substitute instead of this. I am going to substitute. So substitute 14 in 13. So it becomes D2 is equal to minus D1 by 2 plus D1 by 2 into root of 1 plus 8 FR1 square. So D2 is equal to, again I can take D1 by 2 outside. So I am taking D1 by 2, which is equal to minus 1 plus root of 1 plus 8 FR1 square. Okay, here you can call D2 and D1 as secant depths. So these are the three important derivations we have derived for hydraulic jump. Happy learning.